Hi guys! Salamat sa inyong patuloy na ginagawang pagsubaybay dito sa ating discussions about mechanics of the form of world bodies. At ang ating topic for today is all about moving loads. At sa pamamagitan ng discussions ito ay maunawaan ninyo guys kung paano gamitin o i-compute ang maximum moment that are caused by system of moving loads upon a structure like that of a bridge. Kaya guys, huwag niyo akong iwan sa pagkakataong ito. Okay, sundan ninyo at panoorin hanggang sa dulo para mas lalo nating maunawaan kung paano i-analyze ang beams that are subjected to moving loads. Sa pamamagitan itong moving loads ay unahin natin ang mga important concepts na may kinalaman sa ating shear and moments. At alaman natin na itong shear and moments, particularly the magnitudes of the maximum values, ay nagsisilbing basis in the designing of structural elements, particularly those subjected to bending loads. Thus, their magnitudes and location must be established. Importante yan sapagkat iyan ang ating pinagbabasihan kung papaano natin piliyan ng sapat na reinforcement ang ating mga structural elements in order for us to be able to provide the appropriate reinforcement, we should know the magnitudes and the locations of the maximum shear and moments. Another one is that for beams that are subjected to loads that are fixed in positions, the position and magnitudes of the maximum shear and moments can be easily computed, especially if we're going to use the relationship between the load, the shear, and the moment diagrams. Another important considerations in dealing with moving loads that generally, for beams that are subjected to concentrated loads, the maximum moment occurs under one of the loads. Thus, its location is easily identified. So kung babalikan natin itong ating determination or drawing ng shear and moment using the relationship or using the definition, you would have noticed that the location of the maximum moments are the location of the positions where the concentrated loads are located. Kaya for beams that are subjected to concentrated loads, then we can expect that the maximum moment will occur under one of those loads, and therefore it is easily identified. However, for beams that are subjected to moving loads, like that of the bridge, maximum moments occur under one of the loads. Kung ang beam naman natin ay nasa subject sa tinatawag nating moving loads, gaya nga ng bridges, where these bridges are subjected to the loads coming from the axle of the wheels, then the maximum moment will occur under one of the wheel loads. So asahan natin na yung maximum moment ay matatagpuan natin sa ilalim ng isa sa mga wheel loads. Kaya, it is necessary to locate the position of that wheel or of that load so that under this load, the moment is maximum. So dahil nga, inaasahan natin na yung maximum moment will occur under one of the loads, then our goal and objective is to define and to determine or establish the position of that load so that under that load, the moment shall be maximum. And for beams that are subjected to a particular load, sabi niyan, the bending moment under a particular bending load will be maximum when the center of the beam, the midspan of the beam, is midway between that load and the resultant of all the loads there then on the span. So ito isa ito sa mga napaka-importanteng concept when we are dealing with the location of the maximum moment when it comes to moving loads. At ang sabi dito, if we are to determine the location of the maximum moment, or the location of the wheel load So that under that load, the moment shall be maximum, then the position of that load and the resultant of all those loads that are on the span must be midway, okay, between the mid-span of the bridge or the center of the bridge. So kinakailangan na yung center of the bridge ay nasa pagitan. Ito tinatawag na wheel loads na kung saan ang maximum moment ay hinahanap natin at yung resultant of all those loads that are on the span. And for the maximum shear, okay, sabi dito, the maximum shear will occur, okay, at the reaction where the resultant is nearest. Ibig sabihin, okay, if we have two reactions, then okay, the maximum shear will be either at the left or at the right, okay? Okay, when the resultant is very, very close to that reaction. And it usually happens if the rightmost load is directly above the right support, or the leftmost load is directly above the left support, when all the loads are on the span. So, sa pamamagitan itong discussion na ito ay, maintindihan natin ngayon kung ano ba yung maximum shearing load at maximum bending moment. And with that load, we can now specify and appropriately reinforce our beams, especially when these are subjected to moving loads. Para maunawaan natin itong sinasabi kong konsepto, how we are going to locate the position of the loads when the load is to cause maximum moment under it. So let us try to imagine a scenario like this one. So we have here a bridge and we have here our truck, where the truck will be exerting a load over the bridge. Assume natin that the loads that are exerted by the wheels, which we shall be calling as the axle load, shall be represented here by P sub 1, P sub 2, and P sub 3, representing the loads that are transmitted by the wheels of the truck. And the distances and the resultant of these loads shall be represented by R, whose distance from each of the wheel loads shall be defined. And let us imagine that the distance of this R from P1 shall be denoted by P sub 1. The distance of this R resultant from P sub 2 shall be called as E sub 2, whereas the distance of the same resultant from P sub 3 shall be called as P sub 3. Suppose that the distances between the wheel loads are identified, and we wanted to determine the position or the location of P1 and the maximum moment under the load. So imagine natin that we have here our mid-span. We call this our mid-span, so that the distance of that, the location of that shall be at distance L over 2 from the left support and the same as L over 2 from the right support. Imagine that this case bridge has a total span equal to L. Now, let us imagine that we wanted to establish where is the position of this P sub 1. Okay, let us try to imagine that we wanted to determine the position of P sub 1 so that as the truck crosses the bridge, under the load P1, the moment shall be maximum. Okay, sabi kanina, doon sa discussion na binanggit ko, to determine the location of the wheel load so that under that load, the moment shall be maximum. Therefore, the mid-span must be midway between that load and the resultant of all those loads that are on the span. So let us try to do it. Let us try to imagine that we make the truck cross until such time that this mid-span is midway between P1 and R, or the resultant of all those loads that are on the span. Kaya ang position na ito, if this mid-span is already halfway between P1 and P2, so that this distance, the distance of that mid-span from P sub 1 is equal to E sub 1 over 2, as well as the distance of R from the mid-span is also equal to E sub 1 over 2. And at that position, at this position of the P sub 1, moment is maximum under P sub 1. So, ang kinakailangan natin makuhin dito, eh, what will be the moment that is caused by these moving loads when the truck is in this position to cause maximum moment under P sub 1. So, here is now the position of the truck so that under P sub 1, the moment is maximum. Take note that in doing so, we should make sure that the midspan of the bridge is halfway or midway between P sub 1 and the resultant of all these loads that are on the span. So that if the distance from P sub 1 to R is defined by E sub 1, therefore, the distance of P sub 1 from the midspan must be equal to E sub 1 over 2. The same is true for the distance of that R from the midspan. So that under this load, okay, under this position, okay, the load, the moment under this load shall be maximum. So what shall we do? So in order for us to do it, we now try to establish where are the positions of those load, particularly the load of this, the distance of this P1 from the LF support. And we would expect that if this will be equal to L over 2, and this will be equal to E sub 1 over 2, therefore the distance of P sub 1 from the LF support will be equal to L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2, and that's equal to L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2. Similarly, if P sub 1 and R sub 1 are on the same distance from E sub from the midspan, therefore the distance of this R from the right support shall also be the same as KL sub 2 minus E sub 1 over 2. So after we have computed for the location of the P1, so that moment under this load, it will be maximum, then what shall we do? We determine the reaction at the left support and imagine that this reaction shall be called as R sub A. So that if you are to compute for the reaction at the left support at the given position of the moving load, therefore what shall we do? By taking summation of moment about B equal to 0, okay, and then considering one direction, say for example that we shall be using here, that counterclockwise direction be positive, then we can solve for the reaction at the left support. Now instead of defining the individual moment caused by P1, P2, and P3, because P1, P2, and P3 have resultant equal to R, and whose distance from the right support or from B is equal to L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2, therefore we can take the moment of all these three loads by taking the moment of the resultant from B, so that the moment shall be equal to the resultant multiplied by its moment term represented by this L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2. Okay, minus the reaction at the left support multiplied by the distance from okay, from the right support, and that is equal to L, that must be equal to 0. And from here, we can solve for the reaction at the left support, R sub A, so that R sub A will be equal to R over L times L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2. And then at that position of this moving load, okay, that magnitude of the resultant at A will be equal to RL, R over L times the quantity L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2. Then under this condition, we shall be computing for the moment under P sub 1. And we can do it easier if we will take okay, or consider the left-hand side of the exploratory section through P1. Now, if we are going to pass an exploratory section through P1, and then we consider the left-hand side of the exploratory section, then this is what we will have. So we will be seeing this as okay, the left part of the exploratory section. This section shall be subjected only to the following loads. Okay, one is the reaction at the left support, whose magnitude is equal to R over L times the quantity L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2. Whereas, okay, at that right support, at that section where it is cut by an exploratory section, it will be subjected to that okay, moment. And because the midspan is placed midway P sub 1 and R of the result, R of loads, therefore the moment under this load shall be maximum. And we can easily compute that moment by applying okay, the definition of the bending moment, that the moment is equal to the summation of the moment taken on the left part of the exploratory section. That if we are to apply this moment, then our moment will be equal to R sub A multiplied by its moment R, which is equal to L over 2 minus E sub 1 over 2. And this becomes our moment. So under this condition, okay, ito, since this is the maximum moment, then okay, under that load, moment is maximum. But because some moving loads may consist of different loadings, therefore we have to consider also finding for the moment under okay, the other loads. Say for example, we wanted to determine the moment under P2, particularly the maximum moment. Therefore, what shall we do? We shall be locating that P2, okay, so that moment under that load okay, shall be maximum. And how are we going to do it? How are we going to place our system of moving loads such that moment under P2 shall be maximum? If you are going to consider the definition that I have presented a while ago, sabi dito, the moment under that load shall be maximum if the midspan is placed midway between that load that is being considered and the resultant of all those loads that are on the span. Meaning, if P sub 2 and R shall be placed such that they are equidistant from the midspan, therefore, the moment under P2 shall be maximum. Now, let us try to imagine that we move the car so the truck so that the truck shall be in a position so that moment under P2 shall be maximum. And that would only happen if the resultant of all those loads and that of P2 are equidistant from the midspan of the bridge. So that if this is E sub 2, therefore, the distance of that from P sub 2 must be E sub 2 over 2. But so if that is in the position, we can consider finding for the maximum moment, and at that position the moment shall be maximum. Now if we're going to consider the reaction at the left support, let us call that as R sub A, so that summing up or solving for the reaction at the left support, okay, we can, instead of taking up moment okay, of all the individual forces, because the resultant of all these loads is represented by R, so what we just need is to define where is this R located from B. Now let us try to establish, if this distance is L over 2 and R is at distance E sub 2 over 2 from the midspan, therefore the distance of this R from B shall be equal to L over 2 plus E sub 2 over 2. And so that if you are to take moment summation about B equal to 0, considering that counterclockwise moment be positive, we can solve for R sub A, that our equation will become equal to R multiplied by its distance, which is equal to L over 2 plus E sub 2 over 2, K minus K R sub A, the reaction at the left, multiplied by the span of the bridge shall be equal to 0. And then from here, we can solve for R sub A, that R sub A will be equal to R over L times the quantity L over 2 plus E sub 2 over 2. So that if RA is already known, but and since we are to consider taking moment about P2, because under this position, moment shall be maximum. Therefore, what shall we do? We consider now the left-hand side of an exploratory section that will pass through P sub 2. Now, if we're going to pass an exploratory section through P sub 2, and we consider the left-hand side of that exploratory section, then this is what we will see. So, this is what we will see. This will be the exploratory section of the left part, the left part of the exploratory section. And you would notice that this left part would be subjected to the following forces. One is that the reaction at the support having this magnitude equal to R over L times the quantity L over 2 plus E sub 2 over 2. And because the load under P sub 1 is a seen on the left part and whose distance is A, therefore okay, these two forces will create a moment under P sub 2 and that moment shall be maximum. So that if we are going to consider the distances, okay, the distance of this RA from this P sub 2 Knowing that this distance is equal to L over 2, and the distance from this mid-span to that position of B sub 2 is equal to E sub 2 over 2, therefore our moment arm of R sub A will be equal to L over 2 plus E sub 2 over 2, whereas the moment of B sub 1 will be equal to A. And therefore, if we are to take the moment under P sub 2, by definition, the moment under P sub 2 is equal to the summation of moment taken on the left part of the exploratory section. And what are these moments? These are the moments due to R sub A, whose moment arm is this one, and P sub 1, whose moment arm is A. Therefore, our moment will be equal to R sub A multiplied by L over 2 plus E sub 2 over 2 minus the quantity P sub 1 over A. And this moment, which is moment under P sub 2, is maximum when the load is on the position such that P sub 2 and the resultant are midway from the midspan of the bridge. And that's how we compute for the maximum moment under the second load. But because we have the third load, so we also have to consider taking the moment of under P sub 3. And so what shall we do? We shall be locating the position of P sub 3 and find for the maximum moment under this load. Take note that in order for us to solve for the maximum moment under P sub 3, again, we shall be putting or placing this system of loads so that the resultant of all those loads and the P3 are midway from the midspan. And because the distance between R and P sub 3 is equal to E sub 3, therefore it must be that the midspan must be at E sub 3 over 2 from either R or P sub 3. But so that if we were to consider placing this track on the bridge so that moment under P3 shall be maximum, let us try to find where is its position. Let us try to move the track so that this will be at the middle at that point. We can compute for the reaction at the left support. So that if we are to solve for the reaction at the left support at that condition, let us try to find by summing up moment about B equal to zero. We can solve from for R sub A. But again, because all the loads are on the span, we need to consider where is this R located from B. So instead of taking the moment individually, from P sub 1, P sub 2, and P sub 3, we just take the moment, caused by R. So that if this R will be at distance, L over 2 plus E sub 3 over 2 from B, therefore we can take the moment so that R multiplied by each moment arm, which is equal to L over 2 plus E sub 3 over 2, minus R sub A multiplied by L equal to 0, and from here we can solve for R sub A, which is equal to R over L times the quantity L over 2 plus E sub 3 over 2. And so if we're going to determine the maximum, the moment under P sub 3, which is in this case maximum because this is in the position, the system of moving loads are in the position, so that moment under P sub 3 is maximum. Now, if we're going to consider the left-hand side of an exploratory section drawn through P3, meaning we will be passing an exploratory section through P3, and we consider the left-hand side of that exploratory section. Let us try to do it. Imagine that we have passed an exploratory section, and we consider the left-hand side of that section. You will expect that the left-hand side of the exploratory section shall be acted by three different forces. One is the reaction at the left, the other one is the wheel load coming from the first wheel, the second one is the load coming from the second wheel, whose distances from the third, from P sub 3 are as follows. P1 would have a distance of the sum of A and B, while P sub 2 has a distance of B from P sub 3. So that the moment Okay, that will be created under that load shall be equal to MP sub 3, which is in this case shall be maximum. So that if you are to take that moment, by the definition of the moment, moment shall be equal to the summation of those moments taken on the left part of exploratory section. And in this case, it will be equal to R sub A multiplied by this distance, that is equal to L over 2 plus E sub 3 over 2, minus the moment due to P sub 1, whose moment term is the sum of A and B, that is P sub 1, multiplied by A plus B, minus the moment due to P sub 2, okay, multiplied by B, and this will be the moment. Now, this moment, when summed up, will give us the maximum moment under P sub 3. And because we have computed three different maximum moments, one is moment coming from the moment under P sub 1, the other is the moment coming from the moment under P sub 2, and the third is coming from the moment under P sub 3, therefore the design moment of the beam shall be whichever is the maximum moment that will be derived from these three moving loads. And that's how we compute for the moment. Now, for the maximum shear, if we wanted to determine the maximum shear according to this concept, the maximum shear is equal to the maximum reaction. Okay, maximum reaction, and because we have here two supports, we shall be having two reactions. Which reaction shall be the maximum? Okay, it will be maximum. Okay, this could be either. No, this could be either. Okay, the reaction at the right support at this point. And when would that would happen? That would happen when the rightmost load is exactly above the right support. We shall be getting a maximum shear when this P sub 3 is exactly above the right support. And let us show it. So when the car, when the move, the truck moves, so that P sub 3 is exactly above the reaction at the right support, then sabi dito, at this point, shear is maximum at the right support. And it is also possible that the shear will also be maximum at the left support. And that is possible if the rightmost load or the leftmost load is exactly above the left support. Meaning, if this P sub 1 is exactly above R sub A, therefore the moment, the shear at that point shall be maximum. So we shall have this point when P sub 1 is exactly above R sub A, ang sabi dito, okay, at this point, shear is maximum at the left support. And because we wanted to determine which of the two shear load shall be used in the design, okay, if R sub A is greater than R sub B, therefore the design shear shall be R sub A. But if R sub B shall be greater than R sub A, then the design shear shall be R sub B. And in this particular case, how do we get instantly, okay, where would be the maximum shear? Would it be at the left or would it be at the right? And you would notice that we can find it, you know, okay, you would notice that at this instant of the wheel load, the distance of R from R sub A is this K, which is equal to E sub 1, diba? Whereas if we're going to go back, to bring it back here, the distance of R from B shall be equal to the distance of R from P sub 3, which in our case is equal to E sub 3. Now, in order for us to be able to define where is the position of R so that the wheel load, so that the maximum shear shall be the design shear. Okay, tingnan natin, whichever is closer, whichever is the position where R shall be closer, then that gives us the maximum shear. And because E sub 3 is smaller in this particular case than E sub 1, therefore the maximum shear will happen or will occur when P sub 3 is exactly over R sub B. And that is the time when R is closest to B. And that's how we compute for the maximum shear. Now, how about if our in the case where the wheel load is very very long, and sometimes as we check for the maximum moment, some of the loads are already beyond the span or off the bridge. Let us say, for example, we have here this kind of wheel combination, but And imagine natin that in this particular case, we wanted to compute for the maximum moment under KW at the last load. Okay, let's imagine that we have here P sub 5 and we wanted to compute for the maximum moment under P sub 5. And imagine natin that the distance of this resultant from P sub 5 is defined by P sub R. So what shall we do? We shall be placing the system of moving loads so that this red green arrow load and the resultant shall be midway from the midspan or equidistant from the midspan of the bridge. And let us try to imagine placing it in that position. Okay? You would notice that when they are already supposed to be in that position, that the moment under P sub 3 will be maximum. You would notice that the first load there, the first load. At that position, the leftmost load is already off the span, beyond the span. So what shall we do? The resultant of all the loads that remain on the span shall be recalculated. So when R sub 1 or P sub 1 is already off the span, therefore it is this blue resultant shall not anymore represent the resultant of all those loads that are on the span, because at that instant there will only be 4 loads. So it is not therefore necessary, it's not therefore appropriate or correct to consider using this as the resultant, because this will not anymore be representing the resultant of all those loads. Because when we say resultant, we are talking of the resultant of all those loads that are on the span. So when that happens, what shall we do? We shall be recalculating the resultant of all those loads that remains on the span. Meaning, we shall be recalculating. So we shall be calculating the new resultant. Okay, as represented here, this yellow colored arrow will now represent the resultant of all those loads that are on the span. This will now be representing the resultant of this P sub 2, P sub 3, P sub 4, and P sub 5. And because there will be a new resultant, we shall have a new position, and we will be calling the new position as A sub R. And for us to be able to compute for the position of this P sub 5, so that under this load moment shall be maximum, then we shall be repositioning the wheel combination or the moving load, just that the mid span shall be midway between the new resultant and the position of P sub 5. So that when this will be placed, ganito ngayon ang mangyayari. Ang new position niya will be so that this mid span will be halfway from the new resultant and the position of the P5. So that under this load, this will become the actual position of the load, so that the moment under the last wheel load is maximum. So ganyan natin kinocompute yung ating maximum moment. We have to check na baka yung una o kaya yung huling load condition or loading will be off the span. Maaring lumagpas na, kaya maaring wala pa sa span. Okay? So again, for us to be able to easily follow and understand the concept of moving loads, I have prepared here an illustrative problem. At sana guys ay subaybayan ninyo para mas lalo nating maunawaan paano ba mag-solve ng maximum shear, maximum moment ng system of moving loads. And here is our sample problem. Okay? In a sample problem, I have here a truck with axle load as indicated roll across a 12-meter span. So this bridge is a 12-meter simple span. Compute the maximum bending moment under its load. Find also the maximum shear force. Okay? So imagine natin that here is our truck. And the truck has the following loadings. The first axle is transmitting a load equal to 80 kN. The middle wheel is transmitting a load of 100, while the last is transmitting a load of 120 kN. The distance between each of the wheels are indicated so that between the first and the second, is six meters, and the second and third is 2 meters. So in this particular case, we shall be solving for the maximum bending moment. Yung maximum shearing force, iiwan ko na lang sa inyo mamaya yan. Okay, anyway, I have presented how this will be computed. Okay, so what shall we do? Imagine natin that this is our beam and the span is 12 meters. And in order for us to determine the maximum moment, okay, the first thing that we should be solving, of course, is to find for the magnitude of the resultant as well as the position of the resultant. Diba? Paano ba natin kinocompute yung magnitude ng resultant? The resultant shall be equal to just the summation of the vertical force acting on the bridge. And this will be equal to 80 plus 100 plus 120. That gives us a value equal to 300 kilonewton. So after we have computed for the reaction of the support, then we consider finding for the location of that resultant load. When we say the location of the resultant load, we define where is it located from P sub 1, from P sub 2, and from P sub 3, because all those locations shall be used in the computation of the result reaction of the support as well as the bending moment. So let us try to imagine that we consider the position of this R sub R from P sub 1 as E sub 1. The distance of that from P sub 2 is defined as E sub 2, whereas the distance of that from P sub 3 is defined as E sub 3. And we compute for E sub 1 by applying the principle of moment so that the moment of the wall or the resultant shall be equal to the sum of the moments of the individual force. So that KR shall be R multiplied by E sub 1 if we will be applying the moment summation at this position. Okay, is equal to 100 multiplied by 6 coming from the moment of 100 from the P sub 1 whose moment term is equal to 6 plus 120 multiplied by the moment term which is the sum of 6 and 2 which is equal to 8. So that from here we can solve for E sub 1, that E sub 1 is equal to 5.2, meaning this distance shall be equal to 5.2. After we have computed for E sub 1, okay, we can compute for E sub 2 by defining, because this distance is 6 and E sub 1 is already computed at 5.2, therefore E sub 2 shall be the difference between 6 and 5.2, and therefore E sub 2 shall be equal to 0.8. Similarly, we can compute for E sub 3, this distance. But because the distance from P sub 1 to P sub 3 is equal to 8 as indicated by the sum of 2 and 6. And because E sub 1 is already computed to be at 5.2, therefore the distance of R from P sub 3 will be the difference from 8 and 5.2, which is equal to 2.8. So let us try to keep these numbers somewhere here. Okay, tabi muna natin ito part nito para gagamitin natin siya mamaya, no? Okay, in the computation for the maximum moment. Okay, now let us try to locate the position of the truck so that under P sub 1, the moment is maximum. So let us try to compute for the moment under P sub 1, under the 80 kilonewton load. So what we need is to position the truck so that under this load shall be maximum. And how are we going to do it? Let us try to find out. Okay, here is our load and here is our resultant. What we should be doing is to place the truck so that the mid span of the bridge shall be halfway or equidistant from from P sub 1 and R. So let us imagine that here is our span. The distance are both equal to 6. But so let us try to position this truck in that position. So dapat kinakailangan narito siya, yun dito siya titigil. Okay? So if this is E sub 1 whose distance is 5.2, ang distance from mid span of 80 must be equal to what? 2.6, and this will also be equal to 2.6. Diba? Kaya, from here, sabi dito, we would expect that this position of the truck Okay, so that under the moment, under P sub 1, moment is maximum. So what shall we do? Is to compute for the reaction of the left support, and then we take the moment. So imagine natin na the distance after computing for the position, we try to establish where is the distance of that resultant from the right support. Tingnan natin mabuti, ano? Kung ito ay 6 meters, di ba? At ito ay 2.6. Kita niya, no? Therefore, how much is this? This will be equal to 3.4. Similarly, we can compute for the distance of this 80 kilonewton load. So, if this is also 6, mula dito sa gitna hanggang dito, di ba? And this is 2.6. This will also be equal to 3.4. We should take note that the location of P sub 1 from the left, which is 3.4, is the same as the distance of the resultant from the right, which is also 3.4, because the two are placed equidistant from the midspan. And so from here, we can compute for the reaction of the left support. Tawagin natin itong R sub A. So under this load, we solve for, under this position, we can solve for the reaction of the left support. And we can solve for it by taking summation of moment about B equal to 0. So that what will be our moment summation? So instead of taking the moment due to the individual loads, I will take the moment due to the 300 whose moment time is 3.4. So that the moment will be 300 multiplied by 3.4 minus the reaction multiplied by 12 equal to 0. And from here, we can solve for the reaction at the left support to be 85 kilonewton. So that if that would be 85 kilonewton, we can also isolate the left part of that exploratory section, and from there we can solve for the moment under P sub 1. Let us try to consider isolating the left part of that exploratory section through P sub 1. At ito yung makikita natin. Okay, no? So the R sub 1, R sub A is already computed. Okay, so there will be a moment produced under P sub 1 and whose moment shall be maximum. Okay, the magnitude of R sub A is computed to be 85. So, therefore, the moment under P sub 1 can be computed by defining the moment that is equal to the summation of the moment taken in the left part of that exploratory section, whose magnitude is equal to 85 multiplied by 3.4. But so that when this is simplified, so you can compute for the moment under P sub 1 of 289 kilonewton meter. Take note that this is maximum under P sub 1. Okay, habang gumagalaw yung truck, okay, makakakita tayo ng moment under P sub 1, and it will be maximum when the wheel load P sub 1 is there, causing it to have a maximum moment of 289 kilonewton meter. Now let us try to consider finding for the position of the truck so that moment under P sub 2 is maximum. Let us again show the truck. Again, ano? We are talking of the moment under the 100 kilonewton load whose distance from R is given by P sub 2, the magnitude of which is 0.8. Di ba? So what shall we do? We shall be placing so that this midspan is midway from the resultant and that of the P sub 2. So kinakailangan ilagay natin siya so that itong gitna nito ay matatagpuan doon. Ayun, di ba? Ngayon, kung ito ay point A, di ba? Point A yung P sub 2 natin. Kaya yung distance between the center and the resultant must be 0.4. Similarly, the distance of this P sub 2 from its span is also 0.4. Kaya under this condition, the moment under P sub 2 is maximum. Kaya anong kinakailangan natin gawin? Kinakailangan ma-define natin yung position ng bawat points, particularly the position of the resultant as well as this P sub 3, either from the left or from the right. So let us try to define, ano? Okay, so let us try to locate the distance of this piece of resultant from the left, from the right, because later on we shall be using that in taking the moment. Ano? Take note of this, madali siya makita, no? Because this distance is 6, di ba? Daragdag pa natin yung kalhati ng 0.8. Sa mga katwid, how much is this? 0.4, di ba? Sa mga katwid, this will be equal to 6.4. Similarly, ganoon din ito, no? Itong distance ng P sub 2 na hinahanap natin mula sa right left support naman, di ba? Itong distance na ito. Ganun yan. Kung siya ay 6.4, sa mga katwid, itong ating piece of 2 will also have the same distance as 6.4 from the right support. So that, we can solve for okay, the reaction at the left support, and we call this as R sub A. So that R sub A can be computed by summing up moment about B equal to 0, we can solve for R sub A. So, consider natin yung left-hand side counterclockwise moment is positive. Therefore, our moment summation will be equal to this 300 multiplied by the moment arm of 6.4 minus R sub A multiplied by 12 equal to 0. So that R sub A can be computed to be 160 kN. So after we have computed for R sub A, what shall we do? We try to explore the bridge by passing an exploratory section through P sub 2. Ito yung ating P sub 2. So, if we will be passing an exploratory section here, and we try to take, consider the left-hand side of that exploratory section. Tingnan natin, magpas tayo ng exploratory section. Ito yung makikita natin. Diba? So, on that section, meron tayong okay, moment under P sub 2, and we expect that this moment shall be maximum. And the moment shall be due to the following. Okay, due to R sub A, whose magnitude is computed to be at 160, and the moment okay, due to the loads coming from the first wheel load of 80, whose distance from P sub 2 is given at 6. Therefore, we can take the moment under P sub 2 to be equal to the summation of moment on the left part of that exploratory section, whose magnitude shall be the sum of okay, 160 multiplied by this moment term 6.4 minus 80 multiplied by the moment arm of 6, and that gives us a value of okay, 544 kilonewton meter. So that gives us now the moment under P sub 2. Meron tayong na-compute na moment under P sub 1, meron tayong na-compute na moment under P sub 2. Now we try to compute here the moment under P sub 3. So makatwid, what shall we do? We shall be locating the position of the truck so that okay, under P sub 3, the moment shall be maximum. Let us show again the truck here. No? So and here is the wheel load that we are considering. The distance of this wheel load from R is given by E sub 3, whose magnitude is 2.8. So makatwid, okay, para makuha natin yung moment under P sub 3, kinakailangan mo ilagay natin na yung truck ay, yung truck na yung midway ay nasa gitna ng E sub 3. Diba? Kaya kapag inilagay natin siya dito, gagalaw siya, okay, ito dapat yung ating location ng midspan. Diba? Kaya lamang, tingnan natin mabuti, ano, that midspan being equal to 2.8 must be 1.4 from R sub, the resultant, and 1.4 meters from P. And if you would notice, sabi dyan, it will be noted, ano, that when the truck is on the position such that P3 and the resultant are placed midway from the midspan, anong napansin natin sa first wheel load? The first wheel load is already on the span. Lumagpas na ito ngayong first wheel load. Diba? So, minsan, baka kapag hindi natin drawing yan, eh, hindi natin makikita yan. So, how are we going to check? So, you can check the position of this wheel load by looking at the okay, the dimension. Ano? The dimension. Tingnan natin mabuti. Lumagpas nga ba yan? So, para malaman natin lumagpas yan, so we have to check where is this P sub 1 from the midspan. Where is that P sub 1 from the... So, we try to locate this P sub 1, okay, from the midspan. Let us try to look at this distance. The distance of the midspan from the reaction is resultant, I'm sorry, reaction is equal to 6. And the distance of R P sub 1 from okay, the midspan shall be equal to the sum of the two quantities. The distance of P sub 1 and P sub 2, take note mula dito hanggang dito, which is 6. And the distance of this from here, which is equal to 1.4. Diba? Sa mga katwid, how much is that distance? Sorry, hindi pala yan. Ito pala. Okay, the distance of okay, P sub 1 to R, which is equal to E sub 1. And the distance of okay, R to the midspan, which is equal to E sub 3 over 2. And E sub 3 over 2 is 1.4. Now let us try to compute. E sub 1 is 5.2. And E sub 3 over 2 is 1.4. So when we add 5.2 and 1.4, the value is 6.6. Ibig sabihin, this distance is already 6.6 meters beyond the left support. and it's already of the span. Tamakat we cannot use this R as the resultant because R will be reduced because the resultant will only be due to those loads that are remaining on the span. And these are the loads due to 100 and 120 kilonewton. Tamakat with what shall we do? Diba? Nakita natin yan. Bakit ito? That is 6.6. What shall we do? Okay. What to do when one of the loads is already of the span? So we shall be recomputing the magnitude and the position of all those loads that are left on the span. And because there are only two remaining loads, therefore, okay, we solve for the new resultant. Binago kulay-kulay para maipakita ko na yung aking kinocompute ngayon ay base lamang doon sa naiwang loads on the span. And these are due to this 100 and 120. That the resultant prime, R prime, will be equal to 100 and 120, which is equal to 220 kilonewton. And we shall be computing for the new position. Okay, we call the new position as A sub 3 prime, and I'll be using the reference point as P sub 3. So that when we compute for the new position by applying the same concept as principle of moment, therefore the 220 multiplied by E sub 3 prime shall be equal to 120 multiplied by 0, the moment, the distance of 120 from the same point is 0, plus the distance of 100 from E sub 3 is 2, that is 100 multiplied by 2 gives us a value of E sub 3 prime of 0.91. Ibig sabihin itong 0.91, ito yung distance ng bagong resultant from P sub 3. Kaya tingnan natin, dito sa puntong ito, itong ating P sub resultant ay magiging 220 na lang at gagalaw ngayon siya, narito na ngayon siya. Okay, itong distance nito ay 0.91 na lang. Okay, ulitin ko lang ano. So, pakita ko lang ulit para makita natin mabuti. Para makita natin, okay? So, kanina, okay, balikan ko lang. Yung 300 ay naging 220 na kasi ang tinutukoy natin ng resultant ay yung dalawang loads na lang. At yung resultant yan ay hindi na yan doon, kundi narito na at distance of 0.91 from P sub 3. Tama ka, tweet, if this is the new resultant, and this is the new distance, so what shall we do? We adjust the position of the track so that the distance or the midspan shall be midway from the new resultant and the AP sub 3. So we shall be adjusting the position of the track. Okay, this is the new position of the track. Gagalaw na ngayon siya. Okay, so that here is the new position. That position now gives us the position of P sub 3 when okay, under that load, the moment shall be the maximum. So, yeah, itong position na yun, it which the actual position of the truck under that P3 is maximum. Moment under that P3 is maximum. So, what shall we do then? We compute for the reaction at the left support. By doing the same, ano? So we compute for the distance of this R from the left support, and that distance will be equal to, okay, how much is that? That is 6 plus 1 half of 0.91 of 0.455. So this becomes 6.455. So that the resultant R sub A becomes equal to 220 times 6.455. Okay, minus R sub A multiplied by 12, and R sub A gives us a value of 118.3417. With R sub A computed, so we can now pass an exploratory section through P sub 3, and then taking the left hand side of that section for us to compute for the maximum bending moment under P sub 3. So we try by isolating the left part of an exploratory section through P sub 3, and this is what we will see. Yan. Ito na lang yung nakikita nating loading. So we have R sub A, we have the 100, yung load ng P sub 1 will not be considered in the moment computation because this is not anymore part of the A beam. So the magnitude of there will be a moment under P sub 3 which is maximum. The moment the reaction at the left support is equal to 118.3417. And the distance of this P3 from the left support will be equal to also the same as the distance of the R from the right support, that is equal to 6.455. So that moment under P sub 3, which is the summation of moment taken on the left part of the exploratory section, is equal to R sub A times 6.455 minus 100 multiplied by 2. K shall be K, so that M sub 3 gives us a value of 563.8955. So, and if you are going to summarize, okay, resolving or showing the moment under P sub 2, which is 544, and the moment under P sub 1, which is 289. Suppose we wanted to design the bridge. Therefore, the bridge must be designed based on the resulting maximum moment, which is, okay, 563.8955. So that will be our design moment. But okay, the maximum moment under each of the loads shall be given as this loading condition, this moment. Now for the second question, if we wanted to compute for the maximum shear, we just place, you know, okay, we just place P sub 1 exactly over the left support, and then we compute the reaction at that support. Or we compute, okay, by placing P sub 3 exactly over the right support, and then we compute the shear or the reaction at that right support, and that gives us, okay, the maximum shear. I hope, guys, that you are able to follow the discussions about moving loads. And I hope that with the presentation that I have given you, you will be able to, okay, apply and solve your own whenever you're able to encounter a similar problems in the future. Sana ay patuloy niyong subaybayan itong ating ginagawang discussions. There will be more discussions in the future. Continue, guys. And if you wanted to have more of my discussions, subscribe to my channel and share this to your friends so that your friends will also know and notified of this upload. Once again, thank you very much for watching.